Get that recount done so we can move on with our life.
It's going to be a lot of recounts. I'd like to see it have ended today so we'd know, but we don't.
Let me be clear. In Pennsylvania, every vote is going to count.
The issue is there a road to victory without Pennsylvania being called for a while? And for Biden, the answer is yes.
Hello, everybody. Just another day that the Lord has made, boy. Blessings for everybody. Did you see that intro? I already knew Trump was going to go down kicking and screaming. Poor baby. But before I begin all my ranting and raving that I do oh so well, let me show you what I'm working with. Italian and bratwurst sausage on a bed of white rice. I got my mixed vegetables, zucchini, squash, carrots, onions, bell peppers. Let's go ahead and say our grace. Let's get it in. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for this food that we're about to receive. May it nourish our bodies and strengthen our minds. In your name we all pray. Amen. I got my nephew DJ. I got my number one over there. He'll be back. Pink lemonade, boy. It's the shake 'em up kind, like the Crystal Light, but it's the Kroger imitation. Donald Trump. Okay, his legal team is actively pressing charges, saying that it was malice in accounting.
Chairwoman Ronna McDaniel and State Republican Party Chairwoman Laura Cox held a press conference in Detroit. Both say that alleged voting irregularities and alleged issues with vote counting need to be investigated before a winner is declared in the presidential race. Cox pointed to a software issue in Antrim County. It showed Biden had the majority of votes, but in reality, Trump won the county by several thousand.
And these counties that use this software need to closely examine their results for similar discrepancies. The people of Michigan deserve a transparent and open process.
Y'all are crazy.
Voters deserve to know that all legal votes are being counted.
That same software used up in Antrim County is used in dozens of other Michigan counties, including Kent.
How are we gonna have poll watchers if they're not really watching? Baby, you lost by a whole bunch. He wants Wisconsin to recount because they closer than 1%. Wow. It's good. Oh, before I go any further, spoiler alert. It's impossible meat. Been trying to stay away from direct meat unless I can't take it. He will not accept defeat.
So Joe Biden's win was so exciting today that up until now, I have been oblivious to the comedic gold coming from Team Trump. So this morning, Trump tweeted that his legal team was going to hold a press conference at the Four Seasons in Philadelphia. Everybody, of course, assumed he meant the Four Seasons Hotel until he tweeted this. Turns out someone done fucked up because instead they booked the parking lot of the Four Seasons Total Landscaping Company. Yep, there it is. Like the hazardous material sign behind Giuliani is making me so happy right now. Looks like they're in a back alley. And the piece de resistance, everyone, is guess where this is located? In between a crematorium and an adult bookstore. I just can't, you guys.
Even got Mayor Giuliani out there in that midst of that BS. What is wrong with you, Trump? It's over. You lost. And some Republicans were saying that if Trump won, they were scared that the Democrats would do another violent riot situation like with George Floyd. Probably.
Regardless of who wins, means it's going to be questionable.
Will you accept the results, whatever the result may be?
Yeah, it's America. You got to accept the results, whatever they may be. And Donald Trump will, too.
You think he will?
100% he will.
President Trump keeps claiming that the election is going to be rigged and that Democrats are going to cheat. We've come to Wisconsin to a Trump rally to ask Trump supporters what they think of it all. Trump keeps saying it's going to be a rigged election. Do you think it's going to be rigged?
Oh, definitely. Yeah. Because that's the only way that they could win.
Will you accept the result of the election?
Not if it goes Democratic.
Really, though?
I would not be very happy with it.
If Biden were to win, I think that you'll see an uprising. Because, you know, the silent majority, I just think that we're not going to stand for it. We have the right to, you know, kick our government out if we don't like it. And I think there's plenty of people that would get together and do that.
You want to be there. You know, these ballots, you see, was I right about the ballots? It's messed up like you wouldn't believe. You know what happens while they're counting them? They're dumping more ballots in there, okay? Where did they come from?
Cases of voter fraud in the United States are extremely, extremely rare. Trump, of course, is trying to build up a picture that something is going very wrong at a fundamental scale.
I don't think it's going to be an issue in Wisconsin.
Most people we spoke to at the rally said they would accept the result of the election even if Trump loses, and they think Trump will too.
If Biden wins, yeah, we're not going to be out riding in the streets like other people do because we don't get our own way. We can be disappointed and then you go on.
There will be a peaceful transition. I think if Trump loses, that will happen by Inauguration Day. If Biden loses, I highly doubt it.
You don't think the Democrats will accept it?
No, they won't accept it.
Their fear is if Trump wins, the other side won't concede.
My wife and I both are afraid of violence may appear. And if violence appears, it's un-American.
You want my honest opinion?
Sure, absolutely.
A Trump win, in my opinion, is going to start up the same thing we've seen with George Floyd and our country burn.
If Trump were to win?
Yeah, I do. Because there's a lot of hate out there.
We have to accept what the majority of the public wants.
Amen. We already done dealt with him cheating once. We weren't going to do that again. But it's like, I bet you won't. I bet you won't. But that's not the gist of it. The gist of it is his crooked self can run again the next election in 2024.
Shit. Folks are starting to realize, wait a second, if Donald Trump loses, he might be the guy. And I'm telling you, absolutely. I would absolutely expect the president to stay involved in politics and would absolutely put him on the short list of people who are likely to run in 2024. He doesn't like losing.
Are you serious right now? I don't care. You can run over and over and over again. We're still going to vote you out. It's too many people that want you out.
Way at a Biden event in Georgia on the same day.
Unfortunately, I don't feel secure about what the election's results will be.
A similar fear exists of the other side.
He's called into question the American voting system so that all Americans are now uncertain about our voting process. And Trump has really laid the groundwork so that we would doubt the results should he lose.
I am fearful that he will not accept the outcome of the election.
There are a lot of like militia type pages going up and people threatening, you know, that if Joe Biden wins, they're going to bring up arms, and it's scary. This is the closest I think in my lifetime I've ever felt like that we could actually go to civil war. I mean, it's frightening.
I think it's going to be a very interesting process after November 3rd.
The very next election, my nephew DJ will be voting. And that's just one more Democrat on the ticket, pimp. People now that didn't get to vote are waiting to vote you all out all over again. more people. Cousin of mine seems like she has a baby every year. Her kids are teenagers now. 2024, they should be all 18 to 23 or 24. Everybody voting you out. This ain't that. Look at that. You better stop. I just don't know what to say about Trump. So many people are feeling like Trump is still trying to cheat. You should have known that your stature in life has been diminished. When instead of four seasons, they put you at Four Seasons building parking lot. How many people came, Trump? How many people came, baby? Not that many. Not from the news footage. You standing in an empty parking lot next to an adult bookstore and a crematorium. Boy, what done happened, Trump? Don't you see it? You don't mean as much as you thought you meant, huh? And here's the kick in the teeth. Your wife, your current wife, Melania Trump, she wants to file for divorce.
Donald Trump is having a hard time accepting his election loss right now. And if sources close to America's First Family are true, things could get a lot worse for him. When Trump was first elected to be president back in 2016, it was said that Melania burst into tears when she found out the news. One friend of hers even told the press at the time that she did not expect him to win. Since then, a source close to the couple has talked about their strange relationship on more than one occasion. In the last few days, the source has claimed that it is only a matter of time before Melania leaves Donald, now that Joe Biden will be taking over as president. The source is actually very close to them. It's actually Donald's former aide and The Apprentice star named Omarosa Newman,
who claimed that
their 15-year marriage was coming to an end. She said, I quote, Melania is counting every minute until he is out of office and she can divorce. She's also written a very controversial book called Unhinged, where she detailed behind the scenes of the Trump administration and also his third marriage with Melania. She talked about the book on the talk show Lorraine and referred to his relationship with Melania as very strange. She said, it's a very strange relationship. I have known this couple since they were dating. They got married a year after The Apprentice aired. What I observed in the last 17 years would make your head spin. Sometimes they like each other, but sometimes she is repulsed by him. This might have been confirmed for us after video footage last week was taken showing her snatching her hand away from him as they left Air Force One together. In fact, over the years, there has been many clips similar to this one showing the First Lady pulling her hand away from him while looking at him with this expression of disgust. People have also questioned if their possible divorce is the reason that Melania avoided much of the campaign trial, stating that first ladies have traditionally been front and center in support of their husbands during the election years. But there is no doubt that many people have questioned and commented about the relationship and what will happen now that they will be leaving the White House.
She says she's waiting on the days for your presidency to end so she can file. Poor Trump. My uncle texted me. He said, boy, so much is happening with Trump right now. I hope he don't commit suicide in the White House. Poor Trump. I'm gonna try a little hot sauce. I'm just getting used to this incredible meat. It's good, though. But I'm used to sausage and pork with a little hot sauce. I'm just used to it. I put it in everything with oatmeal. I did once when I was younger. I told my grandmother, I put hot sauce on everything. And we was eating oatmeal and eggs and stuff. And so you put hot sauce on your eggs and sausage, but you didn't put none in your oatmeal. I said, I didn't even trip it. And I put a hot sauce in my oatmeal. Grandma said, you better eat that. I said, yes, ma'am. I ate it. and I regretted every bite. Not because it was too hot, but the tastes didn't mesh together. And I'm just like you, Trump. I don't like to be proven wrong either.
The most important thing about Donald Trump losing this election is that pretty soon we will never have to listen to Donald Trump again.
I may never have to come back here again if I don't get Iowa. I'll never be back. You understand that, Kim? I may never have to come back here again. I lose Minnesota. I'm never coming back. I don't care. I'm never coming back. If I win, I know I'm coming back. If I lose, yeah, maybe not. If I lose, I'm going to be so angry at Florida. Oh, I'll still love you, I think. Maybe not. If I lose to him, I don't know what I'm going to do. I will never speak to you again. You'll never see me again. Can you imagine if I lose my whole life? What am I going to do? I'm not going to feel so good. Maybe I'll have to leave the country. I don't know.
Sounds good.
Joe Biden just trolled the hell out of Trump by literally using Trump's own words. Trump decided to pop off at the mouth at a campaign event this evening, and Joe literally took the clip and endorsed it. This is amazing. You've got to see this.
If I lose to him, I don't know what I'm going to do. I will never speak to you again. You'll never see me again.
I'm Joe Biden, and I approve this message.
That's why I know if you run again, I'll stand in another line 3 hours long just to vote you out. Now you done denounced the KKK and neo-Nazis and any racist group. Too late. You had your chance to do that when they asked you before the election.
I knew this question was coming, and I waited until someone asked it nicely to respond. So no, there's no such thing as white pride, in part because there is no white culture. You can have pride based on your ethnicity, like Scottish, German, Irish. You can even have regional pride, like Southern pride. These things usually apply to your cultural identity, like how you grew up, etc. And I had some people argue, well, other colors have pride, and no, they don't. Chicano, Latino pride, Asian pride, those are not colors. The one exception is black pride. And that's because they've had a unique experience no one else has. Black Americans were robbed of their culture. They don't know where they come from. Two black Americans meet. They could have come from warring African tribes. They don't know. What they do know is their American experience was similar. In other words, the thing that connects them is the color of their skin and how society has treated them as a result. You also have to consider where the terms white pride and black pride originate. White pride was coined by white supremacists. Black pride is from the Black Power and Civil Rights Movement. So one represents superiority and hate, and the other a fight for equality.
Anybody voting for no racist bigot? I ain't. But there's a lot of brainwashed African Americans that still got their hands out for you. Hey, you will have been the only president to do the most for African Americans when you move out the White House. Oh, maybe it's me. Look at the onions. You see that? And then people talking about Kamala. Are you serious? Proud black woman.
Did Joe Biden just win the presidency? The first female vice president is a black woman!
Tension. I don't think you heard her. I had to beat the hair and the face for this one. The very first female vice president is a black woman, and that's on period.
Proud Indian woman. Proud Indian black woman.
You see this? You see this right here? See, this is what we're not finna do. Not in 2020. We're not about to put two amazing black women against each other, okay? First of all, Kamala Debbie Harris is half Jamaican and half Indian. She loves both sides, period. Kamala Debbie Harris was born in Oakland, California. Kamala Debbie Harris went to the prestigious HBCU known as Howard University. Kamala Debbie Harris is a member of the Divine Nines, aka sorority. Kamala Debbie Harris was just the second black woman ever elected into the U.S. Senate. And Kamala Debbie Harris is the only black woman in the U.S. Senate today. So what we're going to start doing is putting some goddamn respect on Kamala Debbie Harris's name and not lying about her blackness just because we don't like her. Period.
And you're beautiful, girl. I'm sorry for dripping, but drip is what I do. You glow. And she's family oriented. Next time that you see me, I'm walking up. Both of them are. Joe Biden and Kamala Harris. What you been up to, Aiden? I've been dancing in my room, swaying my feet, trying to get you love and a kiss on the cheek, caught in candy skies like I'm stuck in a dream, and I've been feeling blue, you're the one that I need, dancing in my room, swaying my feet, trying to get you love and a kiss on the cheek. Hey Mina, that's my girl, she don't even know it. Goodbye, Trump. Take it back. Bye, Felicia. I don't know what to tell you. Oh, yeah. No. So, what do y'all think Trump gonna do? Talking about the votes in Pennsylvania, Wisconsin, whatever.
Hey, Mrs. Puff, what's my final score?
6.
Woo! And how many do I need to pass?
6.
Ooh!
100.
What?
All of this with the global warming and that, a lot of it's a hoax.
It'll start getting cooler. You just watch.
And I see again the forest fires are starting. I said, gotta clean your floors.
I don't think science knows, basically.
I'm an environmentalist. A lot of people don't understand that. I have done more.
I'm Joe Biden, and I approve this message.
But we ain't got nothing to hide. You lost. And I'm sure all the American people that voted for Biden and who voted for Trump will vote the same way again. And you're still gonna lose. I ain't gonna worry about it. God got us. And Mayflower Movie Company got you, Donald. Everything's so good. If you guys like what you've seen here, like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll talk to you guys soon.